Hi everybody, Broken Ebes here and welcome to today's video. Today's video is episode 2 in our Farm Simulator 2013 career on our chosen map, of course, is Hegenstedt. So let's load up. I can't remember what we did last time or where we were. I know we shifted all the buggies, didn't we? That's about it. That's about all I can remember. But nevertheless, this is one game, along with the trucking and War Thunder, that I just cannot get enough of. There's just not enough hours in the day for me, to be honest. Just saying. I hope you're all safe and well. I hope you're all enjoying the pants out of whatever it is you're doing. I hope you're all having great fun. Oh, yeah. I remember. So one thing I'm really enjoying in this game is the contracting. Yeah, I'm 10 more than that. But we are going to go down very shortly. So you do need to think before you do a mowing contract, because it might take you 3 hours to get there. We've currently got 15,000 quid in the bank. I think we paid the loan off, if I remember right. Yep, we've got no loan. We need to do one or two things. We need to start growing stuff. Just putting that out there. And we also need to do contracting in downtimes. To swell the coffers as such. So we'll see how we get on. Hopefully the audio is okay for you. I do struggle with the audio, I don't know why. I just do. Let me just have a look at what's growing. 16's growing. That's right. I must have been planting. Okay, well, we'll use a worker for this. I have got rid of the red classic tractors and gone for a couple of really old Massey Ferguson's, because they are not only super uber cheap to buy, but super uber cheap to run. So I've gone for a front loader for contracting. And a regular tractor for farm work. Both are slow, but they do get the job done, just saying. So I think what we'll do is finish planting up that field and we'll see what contracts we get coming. Of course, while that's planting, well, we could be mowing. Disabled grass pickup, is that O or Q? It's O. Yeah, so there's no grass pickup. So we can turn on the mower and tidy up the farm. Just saying. You gotta love these little mowers. And it won't pick the grass up. It will just mow it, which is fine. I can't remember if we bought a forager. I don't think we have we? So we need to save up and buy a forager so that, again, we can sell the grass. Of course, I could use this, but at the speed with which this thing runs. If we put the grass pickup on, maybe we can sell the grass for extra dollar. Win-win, I guess. And it stops it spreading it all over the shop as well, which is nice, really. God, my driving is just shocking, isn't it? Really shocking. Okay. Let's get mowing. Let's get some free dollar. It's only going to be a couple of hundred quid. A bucket, I would have thought, even if that, to be honest. but nevertheless it keeps the farm tidy, and it's $3 and we don't have to leave the farm. Even better. Although I can't see this grass very well in the shade at all, just saying. It's definitely picking it up, which is good. Good for us. Gotta love these little mowers. I love little touches like this in Farm Sim 13 that you just don't get as standard in 17. You've got to buy mowers and strap them to the back of a great big tractor. This might be slow, but oh man, it's just so easy and such fun. Here we go. So, cold cargo. During a food transport, a refrigerator box was left behind. Fetch it, bring it to its destination. We get 7 minutes and it's worth $10,000. Well, it depends whereabouts on the map it is. Well, the other thing is, there's no time limit on contracting, which is nice. In terms of the contract doesn't start. Let's turn the mower off. Let's just see if we can sell this bit of grass we've got. And see if we get in a dollar, because then we'll know, won't we? I'm guessing we sell it here. I'm not 100% sure. And then while that other field's being planted, we can go and do this contract. Yeah, I thought so. Let's see if we actually get any dollar for it. Oh, love it. Love the animations. So damn cool. There it goes. Yeah, and we're getting dollar for it. So, that's an activity that's well worth doing for us. Absolutely loving this game. So damn good, and it runs so beautifully on Linux Mint. I'm guessing because it's old and because the requirements are very low, you could probably play this on a real potato of a PC. Right, so let's go make a pig's ear of this contract. Our little Massey isn't very quick at all, so it's going to take us a bit of time to get there. And the timer doesn't start until we lift the pallet off its base, then the timer begins. So, pretty darn cool. I absolutely fucking love this game, I really do. It's so good. I love the interface. It's so uniquely different to all the other farm simulators. I love the PDA. Everything's functional, everything works. It's just deep joy, really. Deep joy. Okay. Hopefully that other field will be planted by the time we get through these shenanigans. So we've literally got to follow this road all the way. Look at this grass that we can harvest. Just amazing. The front loader we can also use as an ordinary tractor. I have put a huge weight on the back just to counterbalance the weight of the pallets that we might pick up. Could have gone down that way. The other beauty of contracts in this game is it really does encourage you to explore and enjoy the map. So obviously the contracts will send you all over the shop. Didn't really want to come this way, did I? I don't know if I can do this, but we'll try. Ebsy's dodgy shortcuts. And it really does allow you to get used to the map and the different areas. And I guess really the goal for me is to own every single field on the map. That's my ultimate goal. We could do it just via agro farming. We could also do livestock and all sorts of other shenanigans, but nevertheless I'm going to do a mixture of agro farming and contracting, and then mowing the grass in the downtime and selling that, and that should allow us to earn plenty of money to buy other fields. The field prices on this, the original map that comes supplied with the game, are pretty good. They're not bad, not bad at all. Oh, we've got traffic switched on. That might be a pain in the neck a little bit later on. But anyway, we'll leave it on for now. Just excuse me while I have a slurp of the coffee. Gotta be done. For those of you that are wondering, I'm healing quite well. I'm still in an awful lot of pain on a regular daily basis, unfortunately. But hey ho, it's the way it is, we get on with it. Absolutely loving the gaming again. Haven't been out in Marfish really, other than to fetch stuff. Oh, here's the golf course. Since I actually had my stroke, I tend to do everything in the bedroom, so you could call me bedders boy. And that's the current state of play. I am on the main gaming PC. I am on Linux Mint. Although I do also have my secondary PC with MX Linux on it. So if any of you think I've dumped MX Linux, well, you're wrong. It's just that I've pretty much finished now setting up, and it takes such a long while to set your PC up, your games up, download all the mods that you want, you know, configure them, set them up, and once it's done, it's terrific. But doing it is pretty darn time consuming, so I'm looking for a pallet. And then even if I can find the pallet, that's not the end of it. There it is. So, of course, we're right at the arse end, back of beyond nowhere. I'm looking for holes in the pallet. Yeah. Okay. So, remember the timer won't start until we lift the pallet up. If any of you think this is an easy thing to do, mightily fucking wrong you'd be. Because it's quite a finicky thing to do, as this is an earlier iteration of the game. Getting yourself lined up right will pay dividends, although it might appear to be a bit of a pain in the nutshells. Very difficult with me having suffered the stroke to get this right. There we go. Ish. Really? Uh, Well done. So now the time has started, look. Well done. How to make an absolute pig's ear of it. Great. And now the fucking pallet's the wrong way. So I think it's safe to say I've made a pig's ear of that. Come on, tip over, bitch. No, we've chuffed this ride up. It wants to come this way. There we go. Well, I think it's safe to say we fucked it. but as I say, I just can't get enough of this game, really. Oh my god, the physics in this game are mental. So yeah, that's fuck that. So all this way for nothing. Because we're never going to get that tipped over. Just not going to happen. It just will not go back on its arse, look. Oh, it will slide for England. See you later. Right, okay, so that's that fucked. I told you the game isn't easy. It's not. It's not as cut and dried as you think. You know, you think older game, piece of piss. Well, it's not for me. Maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just shite at it. But nevertheless, I just can't get enough of it. I just love it to bits. I love this game so much. As I say, this the trucking and the War Thunder. In case any of you were wondering, the War Thunder warship video that I did, where I said if you're playing World of Warships, well, it sucks to be you. Don't be under any illusions. The parent company of War Thunder, Gaiji, are just as bad as the parent company of World of Warships, which is, of course, Wargaming. I just think that War Thunder, with having it all in one, so you've got tanks, you've got your blue water fleet, your coastal ships and your aircraft, having it all in one, well, I just think it's fantastic. I've just finished downloading and installing the high res texture pack as well, which is free on Steam for War Thunder. So I just personally prefer the shit that War Thunder throws at you compared to the shit that Wargaming throw at you. Now, both games want you to get the credit card out. That's why they're both grindy as feck. However, the big difference between Gaijin and Wargaming is Gaijin and War Thunder haven't twigged on to gambling with loot boxes, whereas Wargaming absolutely fleece their players with gambling. I just think it's wrong. And that's not even including the fact that both World of Warships and World of Tanks are microcosm shitfests. So that's just my personal tenpenneth. If you play World of Warships or World of Tanks, that's fine. That's your choice. You might. I mean, this game looks fucking amazing, doesn't it? Oh my god, 2013, it looks amazing. Yeah, if you play those games, then good luck to you. Enjoy, knock yourselves out. Because at the end of the day, you need to do what works for you and what floats your boat. Me, I'm a very, very happy boy. And on this quality of PC, I know if my graphics card packs up, it's going to cost me about 90 quid for a brand new one. I might even buy a brand new one and keep it as a spare just in case. Other than that, we're good to go. This game looks fantastic. I don't know what it's going to look like on your screens, but oh my actual god. And as I say, the trucking's going really well, both Euro Truck and American Truck. I'm having tons and tons of fun with that. I might put American Truck back to my 135 series and continue that, because I think it offers more fun options, and save the serious 150 for Euro Truck. Anyway, I'm trying to make my way back to my farm. Haven't got a Danny Leroux. You can preset the amount of time you want the contracts to pop up, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, whatever. The default is 10 minutes. I think I've got it set on 5 minutes for contracts. Wow, this game looks fucking awesome. 2013 people, well actually 2012 it was crafted, 2013 it was released. You can pick it up on Steam sale for a couple of quid, and it will give you hundreds if not thousands of hour of pleasurable gaming, and of course 100% suitable for children, grandchildren, wives, girlfriends. And hey, you might just learn something about farming while you're playing. I absolutely love it. It's fantastic. And there's so many different activities that you can do to soak your time up. You're tantamount to being spoiled. Absolutely bloody spoiled. Hey ho, this is just me, post-stroke, and a happy little shitter I am. Okay, let's see how Quedmo's doing on this field. He's nearly done. Now at this stage, because we've only got 15,000 quid in the bank, not the time is going out in a minute, I'm not going to fertilise for a start. We're going to grow canola. We're going to flog the canola. Excuse me. There we go. Mission failed. You didn't deliver it in time, big boy. That's alright. We can live with that. Some missions are successful. Some are just a utter total bust. I'm just trying to think of ways of doing it quicker. I guess I could buy a flatbed trailer for pallet work. Trailers, tippers. You really want a tipper. Cultivators, plows, sowing. Manure spreaders. Slurry tanks, mowers, windrowers, tedderers, loading wagons, oh, baling tedder, there we go. We could buy ourselves a flatbed trailer, I guess. Dump the pallet on the flatbed trailer, bez it. Not sure that's going to work actually, but. Because you don't get a lot of time to complete the missions at all. I have installed custom textures on this game as well, and that's probably one of the other reasons why it looks so darn good. And I am actually being unproductive here, because what we could do is we could get mowing while we're sat there doing nothing rather than watching Matey Boy. We could tidy the field up. Is gathering on? Yep, it is. So we've actually got gathering on. I'm guessing this is not going to hold a lot, but anyway. Let's turn on said mower. And let's get mowing. We don't need the PDA on anymore, do we? I think we know where we are. I forgot, you've got to cycle through it, haven't you? As I say, I've got to be honest, I've had almost as much fun modding my games as I have playing them. I'm not sure if that says more about me than the games, to be honest, but I have really, really enjoyed modding Euro Truck, American Truck and Farm Simulator. And I've also made the mistake as well of going down the route of skinning War Thunder with custom skins because they're all free. And I've really enjoyed doing that as well. So it's amazing how much extra pleasure you can get out of these games whilst not gaming. Just saying. So I do feel very blessed on that count. I have to say these textures are superb. They're doing a great, great job. And we can sell the grass as well, which is win-win. So it'll pay for the work as if nothing else. I don't know how wide this mower is, I'm guessing. Not very. Nevertheless, it is perfect for what we want, just to allow us to keep the farm neat and tidy and earn some extra dollar while we're doing it. Never thought I'd see the day when I'd enjoy virtual mowing. What next? Lawn mowing simulator. Well, I mean, Farm Simulator 2013 is a lot of simulators. It is a farming simulator. It's also a mowing simulator. It's also a jogging simulator. About the only thing you don't have to do in this game is take a dump. And I'm sure there's somewhere somebody worked on a mod to allow you to take your farmer for a dump and drop the kids off. But nevertheless, I mean, fantastic. Golf course, tractor mower or Amazon, no thanks. We're a bit busy. And you'll find those contracts all pop up all the while. Again, the difference between this iteration of the game. 15, I hardly noticed contracting at all. 17, it was brought to life. 15, you needed a mod to make contracting work, and it was a bit meh, to be honest. 17, it absolutely came to life, and the beauty of 17 was you didn't need to have your own equipment. I don't know if they changed it back for 19 and 22. I guess I'll have to check it out when I get time. I still need to buy Farm Simulator 2011 to complete my collection as such, but there's no rush to do that, as I don't intend to play Farm Simulator 2011 with 2013 being this good. It's purely for completion purposes. So we'll see how we get on. I might leave Truck Simulator as it is, American Truck Simulator as it is, on the latest 150. And we've only got the Coast to Coast map mods, so rely on Coast to Coast updating their maps, which they do quite regularly, rather than having to worry about it. So we're nearly full, so let's switch the damn mower off. And before we go sell, which we can do, let's just get Chedmo back. Now, I do have a lot of mods and a lot of scripts installed on this version of the game, which just brings the gameplay to life. It's not about shortcuts or bypasses or anything else. That's the next field that I want to buy, but that's 125 grand. Huge field. and that's going to net us an awful lot of money once we've earned enough money to buy it, but we're going to have to do quite a few bits of planting of these two fields and harvesting and selling before we can even think about buying that one. Nevertheless, these little massive Ferguson tractors, as I say, they're really cheap. I've not seen them available for any other version, so I don't know if this mod was unique to Farm Sim 13, but I've definitely not seen it in these tractors in any of the versions, and I have looked for them and I can't find them anywhere. Although, of course, 2013 is an old game, so. But what I've tended to find is that most mods just carry on getting updated and re-released for newer versions. Most mods, not all, most. Okay, let's hook Matey Boy up so he's ready. So he's ready to. Now, I did install time fast forward. It doesn't seem to be working, does it? So we can up it to that in order to get the fields to grow quicker. I guess we can drag this out ready to get our first harvest underway. Let me just get the PDA up and check the weather forecast, so we're good. No rain forecasted, so we're good to harvest. And we'll get our first harvest harvested and sold. And then we'll see how many of these fields we're going to have to plant and rotate in order to. Thanks, Walbury's. No thanks. So let's go and sell this grass while we're waiting. Let's get his little warning beacon on. Although at the speed this mower goes, the lights will work. I don't think we need worry too much. Has it got hazards? No. Does have indicators, but they don't appear to work on the standard two-key flasher mode. Hazard warning. Ebs is on the mower, just saying. Believe you me, we have got a lot of grass to get mowed. That is for sure. No shortage of grass mowing in this game, just saying. Maybe I haven't completely unzipped it or something. I'll check it out later. After we complete our first harvest, excuse me just while I have another slurp of coffee before it goes cold. I always end up with a full cold cup of coffee. So as you can see, we're not earning a lot of money from grass. But we are earning money, and it's a fun activity. So there's the field starting to grow. I would like to upgrade the combine as well, so I'd like to buy the Dukes. And it's 30 grand for the Dukes. But could I find the bloody headers? Oh, I could not find the headers for love nor money. And they're all in the... we need to buy the loading wagon as well. And I probably will buy another one of these tractors and a mower attachment for it as well. so that we can mow much bigger areas at a much greater speed. And that's all to come in the future. For now, we're just starting out on our beautiful farm, and it is beautiful. Oh my God, it looks amazing. So there you go. In the next episode, episode 3, we'll harvest this, see what money we make, and take it from there. That will dictate whether we save up for that field to allow us to buy stuff quicker, or whether we upgrade the combine, add another tractor, add a few bits and pieces, mower, terra, that sort of thing. So thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, subscribe, thumb the videos up or down. All right, we'll see you for another wicked Broken Ebes video.